Hey guys, we're about to talk about the traceroute command and what it does and why you'd use it. But first, we need to install that program. So just come along with me, run sudo apt-get install traceroute. And it's going to fetch that from the repositories and it's going to install it for us. And when it's done, we can run the command. So run traceroute, all one word, and then the domain that you want to trace the route to. And it's going to spit out every server that the request jumps from and to in order to get to Google's server. When you see three asterisks, it means the request has timed out on that server, so it's going to try another one. There we go. So let me make this a bit bigger so it might be easier to read here. All right. So we can basically trace what servers we are communicating with in order to get to google.com. So when I type in google.com into my browser, it doesn't just go from my router. The request doesn't get sent automatically right to Google servers. What happens is there's a lot of intermediary servers in between the two, including your ISP, the DNS servers, and then other servers that need to be hopped to in order to get to Google. And so this is what we're seeing here. The first request, this is the IP address of my router, and this is the length of time that it took to get there. What happens then is this address is where this goes, and you can see each address as we go down gets a bit different because we're going to a different part of the world. And the host name will show it's if it's available too with the IP address in brackets. So we can see this is my ISP, and this is one of the servers that my request has to hop from in order to get the information required to get to google.com. So I'm going to try with my own server here. So I'm just going to type trace route pointy bracket dot net. And we can see that it's accessing different servers in order to get to where it needs to be. So in here we can see two interesting things. First of all, my internet service provider, and second of all, my virtual private server provider. And I'm not going to point those out, but we can see that, and then we can see also everything in between that holds information about the route that our request needs to take in order to get to that server. So that's how to use traceroute, and that's why you would is just kind of to, trace the route of your request to different servers. So thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you guys again soon.